Didn't know I'd ever look down at that fan. Zero fast breaks for both teams. That tells you how good these defenses were, both of them. And we scored 82 points. It's a lot of points to put up on that team. And but it was a grind 82. Sometimes you have those free-flowing 82s. It's easy. You get shots easy. Every shot we got was difficult. And to get 82 points against this team speaks highly of our team. And it also speaks well of them. They're well coached and they play hard. They get into you. We did have some highlight plays. It's hard not to keep us from, or it's hard to keep us from getting some highlight reel type of plays. We had a few, but Jeff does a super job. And, I was proud of our kids for how they hung on. Defensively, we made Freeman have to work for every point he got. When you do that with a score of his caliber, the second half especially well, but when you do that with a score, he gets tired and he's not able to help other players, and it makes it more difficult for them to get above 60-some points. And, again, I look down at for the purist, I have to say, I'm afraid to say this because you might catch me one of these times, but they had 38 points in paint, we had 24. They had 14 second chance points, we had 7, and they got beat 16. So, and, I say rebounding was 34-35, pretty easy. But I thought we converted off turnovers extremely well. Almost every turnover they turned, we scored. And I think we started off slow because of, we're still not used to the intensity and the atmosphere with this place full. And I'm hoping that Tri-State, Huntington, students, we're getting a good student crowd, will keep coming, enjoy being with each other, and playing hard, and having a good feeling for where we are at Marshall, where we live in Huntington, and the state of West Virginia. I'll take questions. If there's not any, I'll be reaching.
Helps when Ryan Taylor stays on the floor, doesn't it?
It did tonight. we gave him the ROTC gives us a pin. It's for a warrior of the game. And he got it tonight. He deserved it. He earned it. Ryan's been an outstanding player for a long time and still got one more good one in. Proud of him, and obviously we need him. You know, we need him. But you know, it was everybody contributes, and this is a team that plays together, and they share the victories. So I'm sure Ryan would tell you the same thing.
Two straight very good defensive performances for a team that's known for its offense.
No question. Charlotte came in here shooting 50, 54, something like that. Held them to 30, 35. Got into the Anthony boys can coach defense is all I can tell you. You know, so all those false rumors about they just throw it up right down the damn floor. We play defense. And then you know what? We averaged 84, 85, I think, when we played it. I think that's about what it was. We were defending it. A lot of people don't want to give us credit, but we defended. That's how we got to 84, 85. And we got to 82 because we defended. We went 20 points on turn. So, you know, we work on it. It's not I love offense. Offense fills the place up with highlight tapes. But ball games competed on both ends. And, we stress it. We work on it. We'll get better at it. Tough road trip coming up. I know this would wake up Monday. We're either first or second. A lot better than it was last year, you remember? That is?
I was going to ask about early
you guys
on.
You act like you're afraid of it. See, I'm looking at you going,
Early on, they kind of had the speed of the game that they wanted.
John Elmore's first two shots, I thought were going out of the building.
Yeah.
That's just, they were all jacked up, you know, they just, they were excited. And that, you know, if they weren't excited, I don't know, but that's where our defense really held in there. We didn't play well at all offensively. But our defense was there. You know what? It's a good team, and whatever happens, you know, it's a good team. It's fun to watch. Should be supported, because not only a good team, they represent Marshall well everywhere. In the academic end, on the court, downtown, in hospitals, schools, they go everywhere. And I'm proud of them. They have a super job. But when I say this, it ain't over. We're going to go now. We're still putting that pedal down. We're going to try to run through this as far as we can. Don't know where it's going to go. Never do. I'm not one of those coaches that go, we're going to be everybody. I don't know. If you know, let me know. It'll relax my mind. But I don't think you know. If I don't know. So we'll just play them out as hard as we can. We'll see what happens.
Well, part of your defense in conference play has been keeping the point percentage down, and you can't do much better than you did tonight.
Now, we did that the other night, too, against a good shooting 3-point team. And that's our goal the whole time, is not to give up layups, not to foul, put them at the foul line, and take away the threes. And it goes back to the NBA, you know, contested twos aren't going to kill us. And if you look down there, they outdid us in contested twos in the paint, 38-24. I guess they won by 28. No, they didn't. You know, it's one of those things. And that's just my philosophy. Jeff does as good a job I've seen with his style of play. And they're tough. And next time he may beat me, I don't know. But tonight, I get to crow. And next time I know, he'll load them up. He'll come right after us. It'll be a battle. Really, to be honest with you, that's why I play and that's why I coach. Still coach. Probably should retire. You know, I love the competition, and I think our players love it. And I want to thank the fans and everybody for providing an arena and an atmosphere to enjoy it to the end.
Coach, team 22-30 from the free throw line. Your team takes advantage at the charity stripe. How much does that give to your offense?
When we take advantage of?
When you take advantage of making baskets at the...
You know, the reverse of defense is our offense. Shoot layups, that's getting out on the turn, make 3 points and get the foul line, make free throws. If you do that, it's pretty hard to beat you, right? If you can keep a good balance. Now, they were different. Our pick and roll, they were tough with that. We had to really work. We got a couple, you know, James got a lob in there. We broke them down a little bit. We came out with a play, looped hit them back because they dropped in real good. We got the three because of the pick and roll. But they're as good defending that as I've seen. And, again, I thought, that's when you have to play defense, even though you're scoring points. You have to play defense against a team like this. So it's great preparation, you know. But, and I shouldn't even say that. That is about as politically correct as you can. You can't prepare. It's like trying to prepare for president. There is no preparation. There is no preparation for the next game. It's the next game. I don't know what's going to happen. I don't. But all I can say is that we'll come out and play hard, and we'll be ready. And then chips fall. I won't use the word Bill Russell said, but he said experience ain't, and it isn't. It's always what's next. How good are you at what's next? And so we'll have to go down to UAB, and that'll be what's next. And it ain't even going to be easy, because they're good and well coached. And this game, all these points in here, defense in here, won't matter. We'll get down there. We got to load it up and do it again. Thank you, fellas. Appreciate it. Great crowd. Mm-hmm.